Yo, what is up everyone? It is your boy, the gamer, with today, as you can see right here, a brand new video. This video is about Battlefield 4. You might ask, well, I thought you weren't gonna play it a lot. Well, apparently I played it 5 hours in like a day, which is a lot for me. I don't play games that often sometimes, and I haven't played a lot of games in like 3 weeks or so, so that's a good start. I can finally get back to recording and it makes me happy. And I couldn't play games since my PC was broken, so I basically fucked myself basically that's it. So I hope you enjoy this gameplay. I am doing a live commentary, so that's basically why I'm like screwing up the first 10 to 5 seconds, so yeah. Intro. Okay, hopefully the intro was nice. It's obviously still the same since I love that intro. I made it myself. It was a pretty big pain in the butt to make in Blender, so I'm gonna keep using it despite it's kinda looking generic. It's not from a template or anything, it looks generic. It's my style. I'll be honest, I'm a generic YouTuber, which is, honestly, it's not bad, it's not good. It's like in between, I would say. It's not bad, it's not good. I call myself the average Joe on YouTube, like, yeah, seriously, I call myself that, and I'm like recording, I'm going like, I'm not PewDiePie, I'm not Jacksepticeye, I'm just the average Joe, trying to make a good video that everyone will enjoy, so that's basically what I'm trying to do. And I finally, if you didn't watch my new upload about my PC, I seriously had trouble, like, serious trouble, like, not like the minor trouble, like, a broken hard drive, no, major trouble, a broken GPU and CPU, yeah, that made me happy. This PC is like a year old, so you could imagine how frustrated it is to build a PC. And then find out that it's basically worthless, since its GPU was kind of fucked. I did fix one of them, and the other one is in another PC, it's still being tested. I did run an SLI, but I ran into a bit of compatibility issues with Battlefield, and even Arma ran into compatibility issues, Arma 3. So I did just slice it, but SLI is still not amazing. No offense to Nvidia, it's supposed to be good, but it's good on paper, I promise you that, but it doesn't really make sense in real life situations, like, I reload way too early. Oh damn, yeah, we got an assist though, that's rather nice. Okay, as you can see right here, we're playing on Locker, since it is a pretty hectic map, it makes for a lot of action. I know for a fact, my videos mostly don't have real action, so I wanted to spice things up a bit by making it more adventurous, quote-unquote. I'm not the most adventurous type, by no means, but I can make myself that if needed. It's like, I can adjust myself to basically everything that's needed for me, so most of the times I'm able to adjust to most situations, which might sound kinda weird, but I am. So if I need to be like funny, well, might be possible if I get some training from a funny guy, like a comedian or something, but naturally I'm not that funny, but hey. Everyone learns, right? So, basically you're playing Battlefield 4. You've seen that by now. I've said it like a million times by now. I know. I shouldn't repeat things 50 times. Well, I do. How do they say that? It's the nature of the beast or something like that. And I'm just the kind of guy that repeats shit a lot, so if you cannot stand a guy repeating himself 15 million times, well, it's not the right place for you, so please go away. You know, you can say if you'd like to, but don't go toxic all the way. So that's the only thing I'm asking for. So you might notice, well, you're doing a bit better. What did you learn? Well, basically, I just took another weapon. I basically got some tips, not from a friend, but from like online friend, you can call him. His name is Beltlines. He's an amazing guy, by the way. He's really helpful. He helped me out by saying what weapon is like suited for me. He looked like I told him my playstyle. I was like, well, got any tips? Since he's like a pretty high level, I'm like, yeah, he might have some tips. And he gave me some decent tips. Since I'm more like the head-on dude that goes like a full head-on to someone, well, it means I'm better for the Scar H. Since it has like single shots and full auto, it's quite powerful, to be honest. It doesn't have a lot of like hip fire and shit, but I mostly aim. He saw that too, like, you mostly aim down sight, you don't need real hip fire capabilities. I was like, yeah, sure. Secondary, well, I'm not gonna take the mass lag, that's just plain old noob. I'll take the first 8-pack, that's pretty obvious. Defibrator, I like reviving people. That sounds strange, but I do like reviving people since it's pretty nice. I do like it since, yeah. It's handy to revive people. They always ask for that, so I'm a pretty good medic also in TF2, if you guys are still wondering. So I have some... Oh, that's new. Hey, that's wait, hang on a minute. That's amazing, didn't see that before, like... Oh shit. That's kinda nice, I never seen this one before. I needed like one offensive, that's the one I needed. Oh my god. Oh my god, I finally fought... I didn't even notice unlocking offensive. I was like waiting for that shit forever to unlock. Apparently it unlocked without me noticing it. Yeah, I wait for it forever. That sounds dope, but I did. Since I've started playing the game, I'm more like the offensive, the head-on type, not defensive, so... Yeah, I was pretty much waiting for it all my life since I got this game, so... It's pretty nice to finally have it in my arsenal, and it's pretty handy. Oh, there we go. So it's handy to have an offensive, kinda. Perk class thing. I don't really know the correct Battlefield terms for things yet. I'm gonna be honest, I never played Battlefield back when I was like younger. I mostly played COD, which is by the me that's on this world now, like not the me like from four years ago. Yeah, Battlefield is way better than Call of Duty. Like it's amazing. It doesn't have like refreshes every 5 seconds, like seriously. And Call of Duty, basically, it gets boring. It's like always the same by now. It's like it never changes. That's just stupid. And they charge way too much money. 120 euros for all the DLC and the game. Yeah, that's plain old ridiculous. It's pretty ridiculous. And I honestly don't like the player base either. It's getting pretty childish and toxic. So it's not that nice, to be honest. And I've just pretty much grown out of Call of Duty. I'm like... Yeah, the maps are like decent, but they're always basically the same map. It's never, there's never a big change in Call of Duty. It's basically the same engine reworked to be able to fly with a jetpack. Well, I don't care. So basically I quit Call of Duty all the way now. I have a PlayStation 4, I played some Call of Duty on that shit and I didn't really feel like it. Like, it wasn't like, it wasn't great. And even the DLC and the zombies, I used to enjoy zombies a lot back in the day, but I don't now. It's like, it's strange, I used to, but not anymore. And since basically my PC can handle most Battlefield games, let's say all, it can, according to Battlefield 1's system requirements, it can handle it no problem at all. Like if you can throw pretty much anything at this PC at Ultra and it still wins. At least if it's at like 1080p. 1080p is like the sweet spot for me because my screen only goes up to 1080p, so there's no point of me recording in 4K. Why would it close? Fine. Yeah, there's no point of me recording in 4K because I bet you not my screen is not 4K. I'm a true gamer, in heart and soul, but I'm not recording in 4K since, first of all, I don't want to buy 2 GTX 1080s in and put them in SLI. No. That's way too much money. I'm gonna be honest, I don't have money to blow so I can buy a decent PC. But I'm not supposed to replace it every 5 seconds. Like, seriously. There are people that like replace their PCs or just build new ones for the heck of it, like... I don't. I build one and keep it for as long as possible. I try at least. It's not that easy, but sometimes, yeah, it's needed, so hey. It is pretty nice. I'm doing pretty great. I'm doing 6-7, okay, one more kill. One more kill, guys, and we're like, up to standard. We are up to standard, okay. We have a KDR in this game of 1. I'm gonna be honest, that's amazing. Just for me. Most of you guys are like used to maybe like seeing 7 KDR like amazing high. Yeah, I'm not that kind of pro player. I am definitely not that kind of player. But I'm getting better. I can feel it by my movements, by my mouse. I can pretty much feel it everywhere. I feel like my aim is getting more and more reliable. My single shots are getting more and more in the head. Like, it's basically what you need in this game, like good accuracy. If you miss 3 shots, it's game over. No way you're gonna live for like 5 seconds longer since... There's no way you're gonna do that. That's like impossible. I promise you that. It's pretty crazy though. This game might be hard. It looks hard for some people. In the beginning, I'm gonna be honest, it is kind of hard. You're like scared to shoot. You're like, I'm gonna shoot that dude, but I don't see him properly. One hint, if you have bullets left in your bag, just pop it. If it doesn't hit, well, you're dead. But if you have like the chance to try to hit him, do it. There's no way. We will not hit him once, and maybe we'll get an assist. And an assist might sound bad, but it is pretty decent since it's an assist. It's nice. Always be nice. So yeah. it's pretty nice to see that this game is finally suiting me. I have had it for like, I think, 2 years now. It's like a year or two that I had this game. And it's strange, I had it for a year or two, couldn't play it, so it's... Yes, it's... On at least not a decent setting, so I played that low at like... A very low resolution at like the lowest setting possible. And still get like... Barely 20 FPS. It was like a nightmare to play. And then, yeah, you basically are not learning to aim, you're learning to aim with lag. And that's not a good thing to learn, since... That's pretty bad to see me learning with lag. That's like, it's not even fun to watch. I tried to record on that PC, yeah. Guess what happens, like, whilst recording I would get like, how many FPS? 3 to 5? Not more than that. It's pretty strange since, yeah, it had to do with the heat of the laptop. It's pretty strange. Hey, who complains, right? So let's try to get something going. Yeah, we're not gonna go on a streak though, we're at like 7. Didn't get a kill since the last one, we're like 7-8, that's not amazing, that's not good at all. Let's see what we can do. Let's have a look. We might be able to get something nice out of it. Might be. Might not. We'll see. Yeah, there's pretty much no one here, so we're fucked. We are fucked, look at this guys, there's no one around here. That's pretty deep shitty. Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty shitty, look at that. There's like Belt Lines is now online. Oh my god, that's amazing. Just came online, like I'm recording right now, mate. This is not at the right time. He's probably gonna send me some messages. Not that I mind that, to be honest, but he's probably gonna ask, come on join my server. I'm like, no, I'm busy recording. Yeah, by the way, he doesn't know that I have a YouTube channel. It's like, I don't throw it around to everyone. Like, I have a YouTube channel, come and watch it. No, I'm like, yeah, I'll tell it when the time is there. And if it's not needed, he doesn't want it, well, fine. He'll eventually look it up or something, I don't know. Maybe it's interesting, maybe it's not. Oh, there we go. Let's make sure we tank him. There we go. Because most people don't know the A button. Like, you press A and get this little menu. Yeah, I would say this, it's pretty handy. Most people don't look at those messages, but I do. I sincerely look at those. It's like, if you're not bothering about those messages, you're a pretty bad team player, to say the least. You should at least look at the chat. If you don't want it, if you don't want it on all the time, press H. When active, and it only shows when someone is saying something like in your squad, in your team, or the enemy team. So you never miss an important message, but when you need it, the screen is, most of the times it's like gone. There you go, it's gone. You want to type something, press J. K or L. J is for all chat, like public, everyone in the entire game can hear you. K is for like team, and L is for your squad. I recommend like things for like move their squad, yeah, obviously put it in the squad chat, not in like team or all chat, especially not in all chat, because that shit is just, there are people that like put everything in the public chat, and that makes me really angry, because the enemy just knows where you're going, then it's like pretty easy. You're just giving away your position, that's what I say. It's basically what I say. And what I say is basically what I say, so no complaining there. Please, don't complain. Oh shit! Don't look away, just look straight. Go head on, get him. They're right in the... Oh, we just nailed our magazine. We have like a lot of bullets left, but we might die in the process of killing. That one didn't expect this. Pepe didn't expect this like either. Oh, fuck! Get out! Just get the fuck out of there. Okay, we need a little bit of more... Little bit more health. Little bit more. Little bit more. He's down. He is down. He's down, guys. We're doing... Oh, for fuck's sake. We are doing amazing. Look at that. 12-9. That's like... A decent score. I've been playing for like 20 minutes. 20 minutes? Not that long. Not that long. Like 15 minutes. Well, that's that score might be the quickest from 0 to 10. Like, no joke. Not the death, but not the deaths, but like the points. That is obviously my quickest. I've not done any better than that. That's strange. Most of the time it takes me like, let's say, half an hour to get to like a decent score of 10. So without too many deaths, at least I need to. Careful here. Oh, he's gonna shoot me. He is gonna shoot me. I don't want to be I knew you were there. I knew he was there. Like, I seriously knew that shit. Seriously knew that shit. Like, yeah, let's get him. Oh, we're going to die. Just put the med pack. Make sure your bullets are in the... Oh, did he... Oh, behind me. Oh, my God. Behind me. That's sometimes like the problem. You're like... I'm aiming in front of me and I don't have eyes on my head, the back of my head, so I can't look in there. So I can't look there, so it's pretty annoying. It didn't even behind me in real life, like having eyes on your back or in the back of your head. That would be annoying at some moments because you would have to like make sure your hair is gone, so It would be annoying at some point, but most of the times, yeah, it would be pretty handy, because if you would get backstabbed, like, to get dropped or something, you would see him like instant. Hey, we got him, kill assist, squad suppression assist. Well, that's, he got revived, oh my god, that means I lost my kill, didn't I? Yes, I did. Ah, oh, that's stupid. Score is pretty low, though. Oh no, that's my ping count. I looked at my ping and I said my score is pretty low, yeah. Obviously, my ping isn't that high because my internet is pretty amazing at the moment, so... Yeah, that's obvious that it isn't like a million, since that would make my day pretty damn bad, to be honest. A ping of 1,000, you're getting kicked like instant. No way you're gonna keep playing. I used to have like pretty shitty internet back in the day. It was like, I played Battlefield at that low FPS with a ping of like 500. Try to find a server that accepts that. Accept that high of a ping. Try to find it. I kid you not, it's a real hassle. You have to join. And it takes like 10 minutes to join a game, so there you have it. And you need to make sure you're not getting kicked, so if it gives you a warning message, you might as well leave and join another one, because it's like gonna kick you sooner or later. Yeah, got him. We are doing solid at the moment, like seriously solid. Don't revive that son of a bitch. Oh, I told you, don't revive him. There you go, that's my boy. He's going to revive, isn't he? Nope, he's too stupid to revive. He might be dead since I shot him twice in a short amount of time. And you can't revive people twice, that's amazing. He totally obliterated that dude, like he just got killed twice by the same person. All three out only counts as one kill. I don't really care about that fact. We killed him twice in a short time span, so that's amazing enough for me. Let's try to get some more kills. Oh, that's amazing, there we go. Making sure my teammates are okay, that's... Hey dude, you need to... Seriously, I'm not gonna go to him, it's like way too dangerous to go to that dude, it's like not gonna work. Damn, should have seen him. One problem with the Scar Age, your reload reflexes are way too quick. It has like 21 bullets in a clip. And you shoot them pretty easily, it's like, it doesn't take long to shoot them away. Like, 21 bullets, it sounds like not that big of a difference in an AK or like in the AN, it's a big difference, I promise you guys. If you play with the Scar H and expect to be firing a lot of bullets, yeah, you're pretty much out of luck. Those bullets do a lot of damage, but if you miss a couple, you will get one kill, obviously, but you will not get any more than one. That's like the limit if you miss a couple bullets. If you miss no bullets, well, that's a love story, but yeah. Oh, that's behind. Oh, dude, come on, he just killed me. You're gonna revive me now? You're too stupid to revive. It looks like a medic to me. Yeah, that kind, yeah, that dude right there. Yeah, that's stupid. He's not even bothering. That's like, there's one problem. If there are always medics like in this game that don't do shit, just stand there shooting. I kid you not, that's not the point of being a medic. They don't have amazing guns. Be supportive when they shoot. Like seriously though, but I should be. Just go support. It's not that hard to see why everyone goes medic. They have a med pack for themselves. But did you know you can share the med pack? Yes, you can. It's like, it's actually genuinely amazing. You can throw it on the ground and other people can use it. Like, you throw it on the ground and another dude can pick it up. Isn't that lovely? It's like sharing. It's amazing. You should try it. It's like the amazing thing in Battlefield. You can throw a med pack. And everyone will be happy and you get free score. Free score, like, not even a scam, like, you legit get free scores. There we go. Isn't... yeah. Oh my god, no, fuck. What a stupid name, to be honest. Look at that name, like... _. That's a stupid name, to be honest. Hey, wait a minute. I'm reviving too, to be honest, that's not fair. That's basically shit, I don't revive. There you go. But I promise I make pretty clear I do. Yeah, shit, I got killed. Yeah, bye. I'm thinking about ending it here, guys. We had a pretty nice match. I'm not gonna be able to finish it on camera, so it's like 36 more minutes. No way we're gonna get like 20,000 kills. In no obvious way. It has been a lot of fun for me. I hope you guys enjoyed this little team deathmatch. It's more like a teaser of what I can basically do in Battlefield. It's like, It's basically these and nothing more than that. But why did I throw a mat back at my friend? No problem. So guys, I hope you really liked this. I hope it's an awesome video. I will edit it as much as I can. It won't be like good out or anything. I like my videos raw, let's keep it like that. I like my videos like I like my meat raw. I don't actually like raw meat, but hey. So, hey, that's basically it. If you guys enjoyed this video, do 3 things for me. Just like this video. A like helps amazingly. And liking is combined with sharing. Like, you share the video on Facebook. More people can watch the video. And like you will automatically gain more friends. That's pretty obvious, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Pretty much. So you share the video, you like the video. More people join the video, more people join the channel. I'm happy. Yeah, that seems legit, doesn't it? Yeah, it's legit. I promise you, it's all legit. You subscribe. If you subscribe, you're like an awesome dude. I promise you. You're like the awesome dude. Like the other 520 awesome dudes on this channel at this very moment. So you're like the other one. You're like 521 if you subscribe right now. And that's a special number because it means you're like starting the train, because I quit it. I couldn't upload from 520. So if you start the train by subscribing, yeah. Basically the bet for my channel, that's amazing if you would do that. So please, anyone who sees this, subscribe if the counter is at 520. I promise you're the first one to subscribe. Just try subscribing, it's amazing. Don't like my content, say what's wrong. If I really don't want to change it, well, unsub. Unsubbing is an option, you know, like you can unsub from a person. I liked PewDiePie back in the day. No joke. Still kinda like him sometimes. But it doesn't get my sub because I don't like most of his content. Like one or two videos are good and the rest is not that good. So it basically means if you can always unsub and resub. Don't do it too often though, because that would make the creator pretty mad, to say the least. So if you did that, don't forget to give this video a big share on every social media platform you can find. If you think you don't have like a proper way to share, like you don't have enough friends, well, buy some friends. Just basically buy some. No, just kidding, by the way. If you wanna share a video, just... Or, hey, give my name of my channel. If you type my name exactly into YouTube, doesn't have to be with the caps correct. People can obviously find me. It's like, I'm not that known, but they can at least find my channel, so... Hey, that's nice. And if you did all those 3 things, I know I keep rambling on, you would be an awesome dude. If you did those every single time I uploaded, you would really make my day. And if you would keep it up for a year, well, I might even have a special video thanking you, and only you. And maybe the other dudes and dudettes that did this. So if you keep retweeting, sharing everything I can possibly think of, well, that makes not an awesome dude of you. Because I'm trying to get bigger on YouTube, but it's not easy. To say the least, it's hard. I've been doing this since 2011, 2012, and it's getting harder with more competition. Back in days, like 20 views was normal for me, but it still is normal. It's like the normal count, but it doesn't increase. It hasn't really increased over the years. Because my content has stayed the same. Minecraft. For years I've been uploading that Minecraft game. Yep. Guess what? Not gonna bother doing that anymore, since it's basically nothing. It's not my style anymore. I do like it a bit, especially in VR with HTC5, but that's about it. And it's pretty hard to record HTC5, so... Yeah, I'm not gonna try doing that because I don't wanna ruin my HTC5, since it's a... Let's say it's a pretty expensive toy. Yeah, let's say it like that, okay. Here's Courage, I saw that one coming. So guys, if you like this video, do those 3 things, and basically that's it. I'm gonna stop rambling on. Everyone, gamer out. Till the next one, ciao guys. And by the way, if you have a good or decent PC, just try this Battlefield game. It's better than COD, I promise you. And if you're a COD kid and you don't like Battlefield, well, keep playing COD till you get bored of the other ones, of every COD of in existence. Try Battlefield and expect to be amazed, I guess. Like, everyone, see you later. Gamer out.